thank you for joining us today for our webinar entitled Swift Estimator for Residential Appraising, the Benefits to Your Business. My name is Mark Patnaud. I'm the Vice President of Sales for Bradford Technologies and your host for today's event. We are very pleased to have so many of you joining us today, as we have a very large audience comprised of both ClickFORMS, current ClickFORMS customers with Bradford Technologies, and guests using other software vendors just wanting to learn more about SwiftEstimator and its benefits. So welcome to both groups. A couple of housekeeping notes to start. All of you are on mute, but please feel free at any time to type questions into the comments or chat box at the right-hand side of your screen. We will hopefully have time to address all of your questions at the end of today's presentation, but if not, we will follow up with you individually via an emailed response. We'll also reprint all the questions and provide them with the answers to everyone via email as well. So first, let's go to some introductions for today to introduce our speakers, our panelists. The first will be Al Negron with Marshall & Swift. He's a trainer for Marshall & Swift. And the second individual we have on today is Chris Shortkin. He's a Bradford Technologies trainer and a technical support engineer. Some of you may have spoken to him in the past. So real quickly, and just real briefly, the point and purpose of today's event is a continuation of our education and promotion series we started January 1st here at Bradford Technologies. We started a new promotion or a new model in 2013 that had really three goals in mind. The first goal is relative to development. So it's a goal to build solutions for our customers that will maximize your productivity, efficiency, and an appraiser's ability to make money. We know you're very busy, especially now, and so tools that help you speed up what you do, yet not compromising accuracy, and making your business more efficient is our development focus. The second goal is to seek out partnerships that provide a benefit to an appraiser's day-to-day job requirements. And the third goal is to educate our base on the products and services we offer to make sure there is a full understanding of why we offer them. So Marshall & Swift is one such partner in their service called Swift Estimator. We have had on our product sheet for many years now. They're not the cheapest cost estimating solution in the industry, but they are without the doubt one of, if not the best in the industry. So we want you to know why they are worth the investment to your business, and you know, whether you're a ClickForms customer or not. For those that aren't ClickForms customers, we hope that this tool is a good representation of just one of the values we offer to our customers, and that you'll try a free trial of ClickForms at your convenience. So let's talk about the agenda today. We'll start with a detailed look into Swift Estimator from Al Negron of Marshall & Swift. Then we'll switch to Chris Shortkin for a look at how Swift Estimator integrates into ClickForms. And then I'll come back briefly to announce some promotions we tied into this event. And then if time allows, we'll address questions at the end. So without any further delay, I'd like to switch you over to Al Negron with Marshall & Swift to take a look at a closer look at Swift Estimator. So Al, I'm going to make you the presenter, and the floor is yours.
You should be able to see my screen now. Welcome to all of you. And thank you to Mark and Chris for allowing Marshall & Swift to partner with them in this initiative they have to promote and educate these services. We've always and ever shall be ready to partner with other significant people in the industry that are interested in making the task of valuing improvements to property easier, faster, reliable. We want to show that we have the heart to do this, that we hunger to do this right, and that there is an honesty behind what we do. That's the purpose, and I'm only too glad to participate with Bradford on this. Also, from time to time, you may also hear from Ed Martinez, who is actually our trainer who travels around and gives on-site training. So for those of you who are interested in that, you can also contact Marshall and Swift for that. But today we're going to focus on the residential estimator. One of the things about the residential estimator that makes it a valuable tool is that some of you may be actually more familiar with our paper products, the Marshall and Swift residential cost handbook, for instance, may be a tool that you're more familiar with actually than you are with our Swift estimator. I'm going to go ahead and open a handbook here just so you can see, and you should be quite familiar with this. For instance, if we are going to look at a cost grid here, so here is a cost grid, and usually you'll have to pick, you know, your square footage and your exterior wall type or types. God forbid you should have types, because then you're going to have to, you know, figure out percentages of this or that and add them together. And, you know, not that math doesn't excite all of us, but where we can, we would like to avoid math if at all possible for those of us who don't have a facility or a genuine love for math. You'd have to do cost adjustments here at the bottom, and then there's another place towards the end of that section where you'd have to do refinements. So there are more adjustments, so on and so forth, to do. And the book has been enhanced and improved to try to make that a little easier for you and give you more options. However, it is a time-consuming process. So one of the benefits that we wanted to point out is that the residential estimator is quicker than doing this by hand. Quicker why? Quicker because it's a calculation engine, and it allows you to do to make choices and to say, calculate these choices I've made, and it does that for you. You don't have to, you know, lick the tip of your pencil and, you know, make all these calculations yourself. And I know that we're all using, at least, or should be using calculators by now, but still, the manual process takes time. A lot of people like that manual process, but we provide this as an alternative. Let me go ahead and get into this, and I am going to put in my username and password. And SwiftEstimator.com, it's not a hard website address to remember, SwiftEstimator.com. And when you get to the front of this, here is the opening screen. This is called the Estimates screen. And from here, you can access a residential estimator demo in case, you know, it's been a long time, or, you know, you may forget even this presentation tomorrow, day after, you know, tomorrow. And so if you want to refresh, you can listen to an audio-visual 5-minute demo to give you a refresher on how to do that. You can open existing estimates down here. It's very easy. Just click on Edit, and it will open that estimate. You can look for estimates, or you can create a new estimate. Before we get totally into this process of creating the estimate, I do want to talk about something else for just a second, and that would be this. Let me go ahead and do this big. Okay, you should be able to see that. I really hope you are able to see that. And the reason why I do this is because I can only speak for the Marshall and Swift process. I am not an expert in everybody's process. But I have been at Marshall & Swift for over 10 years, and I have become familiar with the Marshall & Swift process. Marshall & Swift is in a constant process of collecting costs, analyzing those costs, and disseminating those costs, okay? What you see on the screen right now is a snapshot of the process that we go through. I have no problems if you feel that this is useful information for you to have. I would gladly, you know, give this to you. It's just three little slides that kind of explain some of this to you. We have people on the phone. They're calling suppliers. They're calling trade architects, construction professionals. We get costs from trade publications and labor unions. And I mean, we're doing research constantly. This is a constant process. We update our paper costs once every 18 to 24 months, but in the interim, we are publishing local multipliers, current cost multipliers, and doing further research to make sure that you can update your costs on a quarterly and even monthly basis. The Swift Estimator costs are updated monthly using trending so that each month your costs, the most recently published costs, are adjusted to be current for that month until the next quarter comes out and new local multipliers are applied, and then in the interim we also update the actual building costs. So that is just a real kind of Reader's Digest version of our process. You can read, but I'm just going to read over some of these for you. The component or unit method is where individual labor rates and materials are collected by phone surveys from multiple sources for hundreds of locations each quarter to monitor the changes and install costs of building components. And again, I'm not saying that no one else does this. I am saying that Marshall and Swift does this, and that Marshall and Swift will stand with you behind these costs. The example or model method allocates and builds assembly costs in a systematized approach for analysis against the total building cost. We don't always get a breakdown. Not everybody that we call participates willingly or voluntarily in this data collection process. So we have to do the best we can. And by employing these different methods, we get the best cost possible, the most truthful rates possible. I don't know if any of you work for the government. Let me apologize in advance, but I'm just using this as an illustration, not as a commentary on government work or government workers. But when I used to work for the Department of Defense, I became familiar with a saying that says, good enough for government work. Whatever that meant at that time, that's not what Marshall and Swift is trying to achieve. We are not trying to achieve good enough. We are trying to achieve the best possible. And that's what we want you to have. We want you to have the best possible. We don't want you to have good enough. We want you to have the best. And that's why we go through this process. The sampling method is where complete building cost samples are collected and collated into usable running averages that are refined to a national average base and then to a current publication date. Other useful information such as construction times, percentages of mechanical and electrical costs, etc., are also collected. We are out there doing the best that we can for you. Yeah, we make money on it, but it's for you. It's to make you more truthful, more honest, more so that you, when you hand something in, you can have confidence that this is the best data possible. And this is really important nowadays. Why? Ever since the bubble burst, there's been more oversight, more checking on us, you know, if you know what I mean. More procedures, more process, more rules, more regulations designed for what? So that there's transparency. And so there's still some opaqueness out there. And Marshall and Swift does not want any part of being opaque. We want to be transparent. So that's why we stand behind these costs with you. So you can count on Marshall and Swift supporting you when you use our data. Let me see if I can make this go forward. There we go. Another thing that's probably important for you to know is what Marshall and Swift costs contain and what they do not contain. This would be important because you'd have to know how much you are going to adjust or not adjust, or what you should or shouldn't adjust for. These, again, this information is available to you online in the Swift Estimator through the help files that are in the Swift Estimator. However, if you feel that it would be helpful for you to just have this on hand without being online, I can definitely send this to you. I do not have the time to go over this, but there are certain things that are included and some things that are not. Typically, the things that we're asked most about is whether or not sales tax and things like that are included, and that the answer to that would be yes. Contractors overhead and profit is included, but only to a maximum of about 12%. So it's important to know things like that. Not included, entrepreneurial incentives and developers overhead and profit are not included. General contracting contingency fees or reserves are not included. So those kind of things are important to know, and I'd be happy to let you have a copy of that if need be. Well, let's go ahead and open an estimate here. As you can see, everybody that has a Swift Estimator account has access to all the estimators in it, but we are just looking at residential today. Now, for those of you who have used the Swift Estimator before and are not quite sure you're seeing what you saw before, you're not. What we've done is that we've collected the screens that are required, the required screens. We've collected them all together so that the first thing you see are only the required screens. We do have optional screens, and those can be visited if you need them. They are not integral to getting a calculation. You really only need to see two screens before you can get a calculation. Now, let me just mention to you or point out that if you go through this process, you are getting a Marshall and Swift default, okay, which may or may not cover all the particular elements of your subject. So it's important to look at what the Marshall and Swift default is so that you can decide whether or not there's something in there you want to change or you want to go with it as is. But if you even time me right now, you can do that. I'm just going to put estimate ID is just giving it a name, right? So I'm just going to call it name the estimate, and I'm going to put today's date, all right? The estimate ID just has to be unique enough for you to be able to distinguish it from other estimates you might do. The zip code or postal code is really kind of the key to the cost. The zip or postal code helps the system localize your cost so that you're getting a cost for that area. Construction type is already filled in for you, and more than likely it's going to be a site-built house. That is, materials and labor are used at the site where the house will be. You can also choose manufactured housing, and if you don't have a house at all, you can choose some sort of yard improvement like a pool or a retaining wall. But more than likely, you're going to be using the site built, and that's already filled in. So you fill in those two. I go to the next screen. I can use these links on the left, or I can use the navigation button at the bottom. I prefer the links myself, so I'm going to use those. Here, I can choose what type of structure, single family, low rise, multiple or garden apartment, townhouse, or duplex. Here, I can choose how many stories and what kind of stories they are. Here, I put in the square footage. And then here is my quality selection, and I can get more information about quality by clicking on the word quality or on clicking on one of the links. There is a lot of information on quality in the help file, and you should be able to determine the appropriate quality for your subject. And then we have Reports Calc. Notice I have not had to select anything really, walls, roof, nothing. Okay? That's because my choice of residence type and number of stories and quality and the input of the zip code is enough for the system to give me a number based on the default. If I scroll down on this report here, this data entry report, I will see what Marshall and Swift defaults are going to be used in this particular case and what the local multiplier architect fees and other defaults will be. At this point, I can calculate. I press continue. And when the screen refreshes, I have a report. This is a short report which shows you only the subtotal lines. I can choose a standard report which shows me some of the detail between the subtotal lines. I can also choose a 1007 report, and it fills in a 1007 form for me. Now, I don't know if I'm correct in this, but I believe that took about 4 minutes. Okay? So you can have a Swift estimator, calculated estimate in about 4 minutes. Why don't we just say about 5 minutes, okay? We'll overestimate a little bit. Now, if you want to make some changes, you can easily do that, either change in quality, you can change it here. Maybe it's not average. Maybe it's a good quality. And we can always recalculate. It's letting me know that changing my quality on my building is going to change the quality and components. Okay? So I'm going to say okay to that, and then it's going to let me calculate again. After the first calculation, you have 7 days to revise and recalculate that estimate. Okay, the price did go up about $50,000. Or I can visit one of the optional screens and I can go to components, and maybe it's not exterior walls or not cardboard sheets. So I take that out and I go here to exterior walls and I change that to frame stucco for 100% of the exterior. And I go back to Reports Calc and calculate. Okay, so we added another about 10,000 to it. So we have created, calculated twice, and edited all in about 8 minutes. Okay? So the speed with which you can do an estimate will greatly help you in this business. And we realize that some of you, I went to a conference in San Antonio, and a lot of appraisers are very, very busy now. Very busy. You have to knock these out. Now, I understand that, and it's important if you have to work that fast to have a tool that you can rely on. No, it's not the cheapest, but yes, we feel it is the best. Yes, you can pay less, but what are you getting? Are you getting verified costs that company will stand behind with you, or are you just getting good enough? We want to give you the best. We want you to have the best, and we believe you want to hand your client the best. That's why we do what we do. Mark, I think I can hand it over to you now.
Okay, Al, thank you very, very much. I appreciate your presentation, and hopefully that gave our audience a good insight into SwiftEstimator and the value points. Again, you know, to your last point, Al, we also hear from our customers that, you know, appraisers are just really, really busy. So a lot of the tools and things we're providing, we want to make sure that, you know, they're productive, that they help speed up appraising, if at all possible, without compromising on accuracy and quality. So I appreciate that. We gave a very kind of vendor-agnostic presentation of SwiftEstimator for a reason. We have a very mixed audience today. We have some folks from other vendors, and so we wanted to make sure we had that value for you. We also felt that, you know, maybe some of you would be interested to see how an integration looks with ClickForms. So we have Chris Shortkin on the line, who's going to demonstrate now the integration that we have coded for ClickForms. And if you're not a ClickForms user, you know, this is a good opportunity maybe to see some differences in the industry. Take a look at what your current vendor has for you as far as cost estimates, how they integrate, how we integrate. We'd love to hear some feedback from you on your thoughts on which you like best, or what, you know, your feelings and opinions. So without any further ado here, let me switch over to Chris, and he can go through that integration with you with ClickForms here. Chris, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Mark. Good morning or afternoon, depending upon where you're at. My name is Chris Shorgen. I am a trainer here at Bradford, as well as a tech support engineer. If you're current ClickForms users, you invariably have talked to me from some tech support manner. I also do some trainings. What I'm showing you today is a direct integration of the Marshall and Swift product that we have set up in ClickForms. Direct integration, like we try to do with all our products, is set it for a single access point from the appraisal. So what you saw before is you went to the Marshall and Swift website, logged in, and then entered into the cost estimate. Well, we do that for you with the direct integration. You don't have to bookmark a web page or log in. You just basically have to have the service, be in an appraisal, and, you know, with this great product, it's no exception. We set up that single access point in the ClickForms. So you just need to be in a report, and you can get there a couple different ways. One is a menu way, file edit view, etc. Across the top, we have a services choice. Click on that, and you have cost analysis among our other choices. Cost analysis is the Marshall and Swift service. We click on that, and it gets us to the gateway, essentially, to the web page. We'll get back to here in a moment. The other way you can do is the toolbar way, the default toolbar setup on the bottom row. About halfway across, we have this one. If you hover your arrow over it, it's the Swift Estimator cost estimate. I like to call the icon the snowman with a visor. That's kind of what I look like, what it looks like to me. But when I click on visor guy, it brings me in this, and this is our throughput or our conduit into that website. Don't need to log in or bookmark or be on the internet or anything. Just basically be in your report, click on one option or the other, get you to this point. And it reads in the address information from the appraisal automatically. You have to put in the job identifier, that unique ID. We suggest to use something based on the appraisal, either the file number, order case number, borrower name, address, or even the date. if you're not doing more than one in a day, just so that you can keep them segmented when you go back, because you can redo an estimate within a 7-day window, just like Al showed during his presentation. So I'm just going to put in, and I've kind of already gone through and done the data since Al showed you the sort of throughput of flow of how it works. I'm not going to replicate that. I just have some data already filled in. So in this case, it says redo estimate. Normally, you just get this button that says get estimate, but the same thing up here, this get or redo estimate sort of gets you into the website. It's got an option here, transfer reports to cost approach. That's checked by default because invariably, this does two things. And back up a step. When you go to get the estimate and calculate it, it's going to transfer that data directly into your report. It's going to put the information in the cost approach, and it's also going to fill in the 107 Marshall and Swift form. We'll show that in a moment when it does that. That's the two things it does. If you don't want it to load information in the cost approach, you can uncheck that box. It's checked by default because invariably in almost all cases, you're going to want to put the data in there, but individually or on a case-by-case basis, if you don't want to put it into the cost approach, just uncheck that box before you go do it. And then I'm going to go hit redo or get estimate. And then with no login or anything else, it just launches you right into that virtually the same interface that Al showed for the estimation. It's got the links over here on the left. It's got the little next button or the, you know, go to the next step option on the right. Very similar. Everything's the same. Like I said, I've got all the data filled in, so I'm just going to sort of fast track it right to the calculation point. Got everything filled in. So when you go through the steps and then entering the information you need, either the minimum or the more detailed information for your approach, you get here, you come in here, you can see it, and just like it was with Al there. And all you need to do is just hit calculate. Same process. It goes through flashes, calculates it. You can see the list. Go through there. And then to put it in the report, you simply just click transfer to appraisal. And then it's going to say you make modifications. This is the basically the 7-day window. This is saying, hey, you can come back within a 7-day period to this same estimate, make changes, recalculate, retransfer your appraisal without an additional unit being incurred. So that's the window you have. This, if you don't want to see this screen, you can check it. It's just a FYI. You can do that and hit OK. Closes me out of the estimate. And then we'll go in. It's got the 107 Marshall and Swift form. It imported. I don't know if you noticed here on the left, I didn't have it in my original appraisal. I just had the 1004 pages 1 through 6. When it imports the data, if you don't have the form in your report, it will add it for you. Essentially, it'll do the legwork for you, add in the form, and then post the data to it. If you've got the form in your appraisal, it'll post the data to it. It'll import it automatically. And if you've, like, cloned a report and there's data from a previous appraisal in there, it'll import the data and automatically override it with the new estimate and changes. So, and that's the one area it does. And the other is the cost approach. Page 3 here, it goes in, it marks that, you know, replacement cost new, the Marshall and Swift, where it came from, the rating, quality, the date, some information, all the specific details, size and type counts, and an indicated value approach. It imported this data automatically just from doing it in the estimator, and then again to the 104, or the, I'm sorry, the 107 form, it added all that in as well. If you don't want to use this, if you just wanted the cost approach, you could just remove this form like any other form your appraisal, just click on it, get rid of it, and then just have the cost approach information going in, but it does both for you automatically and for the same unit hit. Now, if I wanted to come in and go make a change either momentarily a few moments after I did it, you know, an hour, a day, up to 7 days, I just repeat the process in the same report. Go to services or the icon, click on it. Got just put in my unique identifier again, and then redo estimate. It'll load it up and it'll make changes, and I just go make the appropriate changes, whatever I need to do, recalculate it. You know, I didn't make any changes, I'm just going through the motions on this, and then transfer again, and it'll transfer those changes back and overwrite any data that exists either in the cost approach or on this form. Now, let's go over this window. This is a floating window. You can kind of drag it around. You can still click in the appraisal itself in the background. It's its own separate window. You can minimize it. So if you're like waiting on some information, got to, you know, that you want to update, or you want to look at it in the form itself, how it actually plays, you can go do that. And then just bring this up. You don't want to forget about it, you know, but you do have the ability to go up and down with it, minimize it, and go back to the report or edit the report if you're waiting on some information, a call or something perhaps, to fill it in. And then go from there and just transfer back the report. You get the same move saying, hey, you got 7 days if you don't say not to save it. And then it puts it in there. And like I said, it's in the cost approach automatically with all the details filled in and this 107 form. And that's how the integration works. We try to make it, like I said, single point access, and this great product is no exception. You just basically go from within inside the report. It does the details and legwork of getting to the site, you know, and getting you into the interface where you can enter in the information, calculate it, and when it transfers it back, automatically loads it in the report and saves it for you going forward. That pretty much concludes my piece on this, Mark. If you want to
okay,
take it back, and do I have to give it to you back?
Nope, I will send it back to me. Chris, thank you very much for that presentation. And again, the point here is we understand we have a mixed audience. Obviously, for our ClickForms customers, if you haven't used SwiftEstimator, that's built into ClickForms integrated, this gives you an opportunity to see how it works. And of course, we'd be happy to go into more depth with you if you wanted to call us and go through that in greater detail. For those of you that don't have ClickForms, you know, maybe this is a reason to take a look at it. And if it's not, you know, one of the these are one of the many tools that are out there on the marketplace. And so you can, you know, take a look at your own software vendor and see how they integrate and make a comparison and see which one's better or faster or better for your business. You know, what the main focus for us here at Bradford is to do everything we physically possibly can to make the collection of data, all of the facilitating of data, as easy and as fast as physically possible, so you can spend the bulk of your time analyzing the data to come up with your opinion of value. So, you know, as we integrate all of the tools, the variety of tools that we have, that's the focus we have in mind, because we know you're extremely busy and time is money. So.